according to you. So it will be easy for you to refer anytime. See, now I'll just how I have to create the courses. So let me go to the administration. So whenever you log in, so we'll be coming to our dashboard. Under the dashboard, if you go to the site home, you will see the entire course list here. So of course, this course list can be accessed only those who have the access. So right now I have given the access only to one lesson for all the teachers. That is the very first lesson, that is the end user teacher's guideline of ELMS. So that is accessible to all the teachers now. So now, similarly, now I want to add the categories. So already I have added the categories here. Many categories I have added. So like KG is one category, class one is one category, under the class one, so under the class three, we have different categories like Hindi, English, Math, Social Science, EVS, Urdu, Arabic, Kannada, so anything. So suppose I want to add a Marathi here. So how I can add the Marathi here? So that anyhow, I will add it. So here I will show you how we can add the categories and the courses. So of course, as an admin user, so I can view each and everything here. See, as soon as I click on Hindi, you can see that the Hindi chapters are showing. So if I just go back one step, you can observe the movement of the screen also, how I'm going, the navigation. If you go back again, one step back, course. So it is coming here. Now, class three Hindi. If I click on class three Hindi, so it will show all the lessons which is available in the Hindi. So if you want to add one more course, you can add it here. So as an admin, definitely I can add it. But now the question is, I'm giving you the access to add and modify. I don't know the order of this lesson, it is correct or not. So I copied the same thing from our school ERP to here. So already I have made this job. So you want to modify this, if you want to rearrange this particular lessons, easily it can be done. So how we can do it? So how to give the access first thing. Very first thing, so how to give the access to this. So let me go to administration. So let me click on the manage. So if I click on manage, so you can see that the course category management. So that will be available once I give the login to any one of the teacher. So subject wise, I'm going to give you the access. Suppose the Hindi class three, whoever the teacher is, assume that one teacher, Shagufta madam, she's taking Hindi class, Hindi for class three, four and five, three and four. So I want to give the access to that particular madam as a manager, so that she can add the courses, she can delete the courses, and she can also give the access to other teachers. So how I can do that? So assume that, like here you can see that the entire category I can see here as administrator, I can see everything. So now I want to give the access to class three Hindi. Class three Hindi. I'm just selecting here class three Hindi. So under the Hindi, just click on. So you can see that if I click on Hindi on the right side, you can see all the Hindi chapters here. So if I click on English, you can see all the English chapters here. So as I'm directly coming from the Hindi here, it is showing Hindi only. So just class three, I'll select English, class three English. So you can see all class three English lessons here. Similarly, if I click on mathematics, all mathematics, class three, I can see here. Class three back, and again, just click on mathematics. You can see all mathematics lessons here. See, now the challenge is, so let me go back to class three. Class three, let me select Hindi. Okay, so let me select Hindi here. So if I click on Hindi, you can see all the lessons are coming here. Suppose if you want to change this name, so easily it can be changed. You can just click on this editing. It will come in the editing mode. You can change it. I don't know. I have not tried. I don't know Hindi actually. English I have tried, even Arabica I have not tried, Urdu also, but you can copy and paste the names easily.
Hua Savera, ye likha hua hai,
sir. Can you type Arabic, Hindi? Arabic, can you type? Abu Umar sahab, Arabic type kar sakte hain?
Kar sakta hun, bilkul.
Done. Very good. So, kar sakte hain, toh ek language kar sakte hain, toh everything we can do it definitely. Otherwise, the simple thing, if you have this lessons, just copy and paste it easily. So, here, short name, how I have given? Third Hindi lesson one. Similarly, wow. So you can just give this starting date, ending date. Starting date you can mention later, but ending date you can just disable it. Just save the changes. Your lesson is created now. The category is created. Suppose I want to create one more category here. So just I'll copy this. I want to create one course here. So how I can create the course as a teacher? So as an admin, I can do it. Let me do it as a teacher. I will show you how I can do it as a teacher. So first thing, I want to give the access to one of the teacher. So just click on the Hindi, on the settings, give a permission, give access, assign roles, assign roles, manager, assign role, go for a manager, click on manager. So here I can see that existing user as a manager, nobody. So, but we have users here, nearly 1,418 users are there, but everything it has not been possible to show here because it will show only limited 30 to 40 numbers, 40 names, name list you can say. But I want to find the name, particular name. I will say they write, just write the short name, Shagufta. So I have written the Shagufta madam name is came here. So just click here and add it. So you can see that the name is added in this category. So just come back to the role here. So manager one, Shagufta. Okay, this teacher is a manager. Similarly, I want to give one more teacher as a manager. Possible, I can do it. Just click on a manager again. So if anybody is Hindi teacher, you can just tell me the name here. One more Hindi teacher.
Nagma ma'am.
Sorry?
Nagma ma'am.
So just I'm Nagma Jalis. Okay. So just I'm clicking here on the Nagma Jalis. Hindi. So just click here. Again, you can see that name is also added here. That name is also added here. Just you can come back to the role. There are two teachers are added here as a Hindi class 3 managers. So these two teachers can easily create the topics, easily create the lessons under the class 3 Hindi. Similarly, same thing for other classes also. Okay. So just I log in as one of the teacher here now. So I'm using my other browser now. So Shagufta madam, your login ID? Shagufta madam? I think I
see.
Yes. I'm just logging as a teacher here, Shagufta teacher 839, right? So now you can see that I'm logging as a Shagufta madam here in the other screen. So now you can just go to the dashboard and you can see that in the dashboard you cannot see that lesson because you are a manager, you are not a teacher. That's the reason it is not showing. So just go to the site home. In the site home, so I know I'm a manager for class 3 Hindi. I'm going to the Hindi. Now you can see that manage courses on the right corner, top. Manage courses on the right top corner. Okay, so just click on this manage course. So now you can see that straight away it's coming to Hindi, and here we have Hindi class 3 Hindi, and here I can see that the courses. So here, suppose if you want to create any chapter here, so just click on this. So assume that this is another chapter I'm creating. So I will say हिंदी थ्री हिंदी लेसन 20 चैप्टर 20 सो विच इज अंडर द कैटेगरी क्लास 3 हिंदी. So just I'll disable this end course. Just click on save. You can see that just now we have created the course is coming on the top. Okay, so now here you can sort the course. There are different ways of sorting of the courses. Sort by time. So ascending order, it will go in the last now. That will go in the last. Otherwise, one by one also you can move here. Up and down, you can move it here in this way. Up and down, easily you can. Suppose, assume that one by one, it is not required. So if you want to shift this to top in the middle, so just use this arrow and you can shift it wherever you want. Shift it wherever you want. You can see that it is pasted here. Okay. So similarly, easily we can just move any of the topic in this way. So you can reorder, you can create and reorder it. So now, as a Hindi teacher, so if I can see all, but I cannot modify anything here because I am not the owner of this. I am not the manager of this. See, I cannot modify anything. See, I'm clicking, but it's not going anywhere. It is lying there itself. So if you want to go and check the other classes also, you can see, but you cannot modify. So if I come back to the class three Hindi, only here in the Hindi, you can see that the setting button. So then once you see the setting button, then only it is possible. You can do the changes here. So this is the secured system. Nothing to worry. Whatever you are working, whatever you have the access, only that you can access. And whatever you are accessing, it will be completely under lock. Hope it's clear. If it is clear, just try see in the chat box so that we'll move ahead. So creating of the courses. So this is one way. This is one way we can do it. So next, I'll just come back to class three. Here you can see that the class three Hindi. See, 17 chapters are showing. So now you want to add any chapter here straight away. You can add it. Easily you can add it. Just click on the add course. You can see that it's a simple method of adding the courses. So if you want to delete, if you want to do anything, so just definitely you have to go to some other part. So just again typing the same thing. So just I will say this one. So here I will say Hindi. Class Hindi 3 lesson 21 I'll give. Okay. So just disable this, save the changes, save and return. So you can see that whatever the course you have created, it is coming on the top. But here you cannot shift the courses up and down. So if you want to shift the courses up and down, always you have to go for manage. So from here, you cannot delete this course. So if I click on this, if you click on this, you cannot delete this course from here. So if you want to delete, so suppose this is the excess one, I have done it. So you cannot do it. So just go back here to Hindi class 3, go to manage. Okay, you can see that you want to delete this. Yes, you can delete this. Otherwise, if you want to hide this, you can hide it. You have created, but you don't want to show it to the student or show it to the other teachers. So you can hide it. You can delete. Anyhow, I have created this just to show you. So we can delete this also. So it will ask you 2-3 steps to delete. So it is deleted. So again, just come back to the class 3 Hindi. So from here also, if you come to dashboard, site home, you can see that the class 3 Hindi. So from here, straight away you can add the topics here. So if you want to manage the courses, if you want to add, if you want to delete, if you want to delete something, then you have to go for manage. Then you have to go to manage, and then from here you can manage, you can do up and down all the exercises you can do. You can delete it from here, but you cannot delete from the other screen. So this is one exercise. As a course coordinator, first thing, you have to complete all your lessons. Lesson names, let it be in the order. Okay, let it be in the order, and make this order 1, 2, 3, 4 as per your requirement. So just keep it ready. So once this is ready, assume that it is ready now, ready to use. So once the chapters are ready, so now the next step is what we need to do. The next step is what we have to do is in the Hindi. Suppose assume that in the Hindi, sorry. I'll go to class three. Hindi. So now assume that like in this chapter, I want to add the content. Hope up to here it is clear.
Yes, sir.
Anyhow, I'll share this video also. If you get stuck, you can just refer this video, and again you can do it. If you want, we can repeat it again, no problem. So now assume that all your lessons in the track, so everything is arranged in the order. So now once the chapters are ready, so what we need to do? So the simple thing, we need to add the topics, we need to add the resources, we need to add the videos. So how we can do that? What we can do that? The simple way, go to the particular chapter, click on the particular chapter. Okay. So now under this, you can see that every topic, every chapter has the same thing. Topic 1, 2, 3, 4. Four topics will be there. So if you want to add some more topics, of course, we can add it. Okay. Every chapter, it shows by default, it is a four topic, because in the main setting, I have done in that way. So if you want to add, we can add it more. So just click on the first topic number one. So now on the right side, you can see that turn the editing on. So earlier, if you are in the dashboard, site home, class three Hindi, you can see that manage. You can see that the manage course was coming. So class site home, if I just click on the class three. Class three, Hindi. So manage course is coming. So once you go to the particular chapter, then you can see, turn the editing on. Turn the editing on means, so within the chapter, if you want to add your topics, if you want to add your contents, so then now it is ready. Without turn the editing on, you cannot add anything. It's just like a browsing. That's it. It's completely readable now. So if you want to modify anything, so next we have to follow this, turn the editing on. So without this, you cannot add anything. So as soon as you click on turn editing on, so just you can see on the top, drag and drop the files under course and the session to them. And also you can see edit, add resources and activities and all that. So let us follow one standard thing. So first thing, whenever you've seen this pencil symbol, you can easily change that texting. So easily that is a symbol for editing always. You just click on this. So first let us follow the standard E textbook. So I want to place the textbook here. Textbook. E textbook. Okay, just press the enter key. If you press the mouse button outside, it will go. So suppose if you type anything, just pressing the outside with the mouse, whatever you have written, it is not going to save. Okay, so text, e-textbook. This is one standard we have to maintain. And next, assume that this should be the video lessons, video lectures. Video lectures. Okay. And next, assume that this is assignment. Assignment. Always press the enter key. So now assume that this is the practice quiz. Practice quiz. So now assume that you want to add one more unit test. You want to add one more topic into this. So just click on add topic on the right corner. Click on add topic. Add one session here. If you want to add two more session, you can easily add it. If you want to add three more session, easily you can add it. By default, always it will be one. So just click on add topic. So one topic will be added here. So assume that you want to give as a unit test. So this is very simple way. If you want me to refer to the NLP, you have seen the sessions. So every lesson we have session 1, 2, 3. In the same way here also, these are the topic 1, 2, 3. These are our sessions. Assume that these are our sessions. Of course, there we have a different tabs like assignment, homework, and all that. But here we can add the sessions, and every session we can add as per our requirement. So we have made, let us follow this standard e-textbook. In the e-textbook, add your textbook, add your PPTs, add your explanation, add your introduction to the topic, add your introduction to your lesson, everything you can add, all the resources here. And then related to that, if you have any video, your own videos, you can add it here, upload it into the YouTube, and you can add it here. And assignment, of course, we will see one by one. So now today we will see how we can add the resources into this. First, we have created the courses, and then secondly, we have created we have given the access to the student, given the access to the teacher as a manager, and then we have created how to create the course within the particular subject. And then after that, topic names you have changed under the topic name and under the lesson, the topic name we have given, the topic 1, e-textbook, lectures, video lectures, assignment, practice quiz, and unit test. And then under this, I want to add some of the resources. If I click on, so you can see every topic, there are some resources, add the resource, activities and resources. So just click on this, add an activity and resources. This already we have seen once. So you can see that by default, it is coming all resources, activities and resources. If you click on activity, you can see these are the list of activities. So these are the list of resources. Okay. So under this, if you want to, you know which are the major activities we are using. So assignment I'm using, yes. Quiz I'm using, just mark it as a star. Okay. I may be using these two in this activities. Okay. And in the resources, I may be using books or files or folders. Okay. I may be using the URL. So let us mark 3 first. So now the star has come here. So these are the things will be always available to you within your profile. So if I click on this, immediately it will go to the star. Without searching, you can just go to this particular courses. So now the simple way I will tell you how we can add the resources into this. So resources, assume that you have already created resources chapter wise. So you may be having the textbook, you may be having PPT related to the chapter. Assume that this is my lesson plan. This is my e-textbook. This is my introduction to the topic. Assume that this is the introduction to, and again, we have some more documents related to the chapter. So what I can do, the simple thing, you can do one by one also. You can drag and drop one by one also. So just what I'm doing here, and under this session, so just I want to drag this textbook to this. So textbook is added here. So now this is single file I added. Suppose you have multiple, so just select all, drag all together in once. So once you have this kind of files are ready with you, within no time, your resources will be ready. So this is all about the resources. Only one thing we have to see here, when you add the resources, it should be, go to the edit setting. So one thing we should be assured that like this appearance should be embedded. Okay, appearance should be embedded. So just click on save. Don't check all these things. So later we'll see everything. So again, here also, so every resource you have to make this resource embedded, open as appearance as embedded. Assume your course, all your resources will be ready. If you want to change any name here, okay, so you can change it here. If you want to edit this again, always enter key. Always enter key you have to use. So you can rename it. Okay. Press the enter key. So rename it everywhere if you, wherever you want. You can just rename it. Now, once it is done, assume that everything is done now. So just turn the editing off. Turn the editing off. Now, you can see that if you just click on the textbook, you can see that the textbook is launching. Textbook is launching. And this will be your material. You can use this and you can teach. Here you can annotate. You can using this line, how you are teaching. Same thing, there is no difference, whatever the way you are teaching. So just you can use that. That so how we are teaching right away. So same pattern, you can use it. So this resources are available for the student all the time. And for the teacher also, all the time, this resources will be available. Okay, so now, this is one. So again, if you want to go back, so just scroll it up, just go back to textbook. Okay, scroll it back, it is coming back to textbook here. So now again, I will open this one also opening within the frame. We have given embedded, that's the reason it is opening. So preferably all PDF files, you can put it here, are PPTs, worst to worst PPTs. I prefer even the PPT also converted into PDF and then you upload it. That will be the best way of uploading the content here. Prepare the PPT, convert that PPT into PDF, and then you upload it here. And this is one. So if it is a PPT, you can see that it is getting downloaded and then it is going to open. So you can open and you can teach, but this will be available. Okay, this is one. So now again, I'm opening one more PDF file. So now you can see that it is opening in a separate file, complete the same page, it is opening in the separate file. So I have not given it as embedded. So just go back. Again, you can go back to the software. Okay. So if I click on this, again, it is opening in a full page. This may be creating the problem for access to the student. Maybe don't know how to go back. Even we'll get confused how to go back. So once this is over, so we'll close. If we close it, again, I have to log in and again, I have to go back. So to avoid that, always give the PDF as embedded. So to give this file as embedded, you just click the turn the editing on, and then click on settings, click on embedded, appearance, embedded. That's it, save. So now turn off and see, if you click on this, you can see that it is opening within the frame. So this will be the best view always. This will be the best view always. Okay. Hope it's clear.
Sir, could you please tell this one, last one? Embedded part, sir.
Embedded. Okay, fine. See, I'll just go back to the textbook. See, so you have added all the resources here. Okay. Turn the editing on. We have added all the resources now. So just on the same file, on the right side, click on the editing. Okay, in the editing, so this is the name. So from here also you can change the name. From there also you can change the name. So once this is done, okay. So in the appearance, by default, it will be automatic. Once it is automatic, it will open in the next page. Again, you have to go back. So if you make it embedded, now you can see if it is automatic, what will happen. Okay, so just turn the editing off and just try to open this file and see what will happen. It is opening the file in the PDF, but it is opening in the next page. Next page. Here you cannot see the software. Assume that like this is just a PDF file. So once we refer it and we'll close it. So once you close the whole software, you will come out of the software. Okay. So as I know, so I can go back easily and I can see that file again here. I'll be within the software again. Okay. So now I'll turn off the editing. Turn on the editing. If I made this resource as embedded, edit, appearance, embedded, just save this. What will happen now? You just turn the editing off and check, open the file. This file is opening within the frame, within the software. So you can use this, you can teach, even the student can download this, you can take the print, you can save, you can do whatever you want. So this will be the better view always for each and every student to access this file. Hope it's clear.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So this is how we can add any of the resources. Now, this, I'll just come back. So you want to access, you want to give the video lectures. Video lectures here. So suppose if you have your own teaching videos, which is already uploaded in the YouTube, assume that from the YouTube, I want to give the access. Assume that the Hindi alphabet song I want to give. Okay, so I want to give this video as my source to the student. So what I have to do, so just copy this, just click on a share, copy the URL, come back to your course. So under this video, under video lectures, I want to add, turn the editing on, come to the video lecture. So just come here, add an activity URL, click on a URL. So now assume that this is video one, just I'm giving video one. So enter the external URL. So this is one. And then again, here also we have appearance. Appearance, always it will be automatic. By default, always it will be automatic. Change this to embedded. And uncheck this display URL. URL should not be displayed to the student. Two things. One, name of the video. And then copy the URL. In the appearance, by default, it will be automatic. Just change it to embedded. By default, it will be check. Okay, so just uncheck this. Just click on save and return to the course. So your video is added. Video one is added. Okay, suppose if you want to add one more video, very simple. I'll tell you one more technique here. So every time you have to set the same settings so you can avoid that. Suppose the video two, I want to add the second video. Assume that this second video I want to add it here. Okay. Just copy this URL. Okay. Copy this URL. Close it. Okay. Close it. Just come to the course. So now click on edit. Make the duplicate. Just go here. Simple way. I'm just telling you the simple way. Video two. Enter. Click on edit, just change the URL, that's it. Just change the URL. This setting will remain as it is. Every time need not to do it, just save it. That's it. So just turn the editing off and just click on a video. You can see that that particular video is playing within your frame, within your software. Similarly, you can move to the second video also. So what will happen if you don't give the embedded? So same thing, it will go straight away to the YouTube. Once you go to the YouTube, you know that again, the diversion starts, the child start playing with the different videos and all that. Okay. So just let me go back and I will show you here what will happen if you don't give the embedded. So just I will check the video one. I will say edit, appearance, automatic. Automatic save it. You just turn the editing off. Now you can click on the video. What will happen? It is opening in the entire straight away. It is going to YouTube.
Hindi rhymes.
So again, I will come back. Again, I'll be backing here to my software. So to avoid this kind of transaction, so always in the turn editing on, so every resource make it as embedded. Hope I'm clear. Make it embedded. That's it. Same. Okay. So this is how we can add any of the resources. So resources, basically, we are taking up two resources. One is PDF and the videos. So rest we will see the assignment, how to create the quiz, how to create the unit test, and all that we will see one by one. So for today, that's it from my side.
Now, excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, all these adding of the resources and everything, we can do this only when we have been made managers by the coordinator.
I will do it right away, madam. Maybe after this call, the subject coordinator just stick on for 10 to 15 minutes. So just if you can quickly tell the name, okay, Hindi, these are the teacher, maths, these are the teachers. So who's the one or two teachers? I'll just right away, I will give the access.
Okay, sir.
Okay, otherwise, also you can message me. I will do it. No problem.
And sir, about the login and everything, sir, you have sent it for SPG also.
You have all class 3 to 5 girls and boys for everybody. I have sent it.
Okay.
You can see here. I will show you the username. I think username I cannot find it particularly. But I will show you which are the users I have created here in this lesson. I have given the access to this lesson also to all the teachers. In the enrollment, you can see that these are the list of teachers. So you can see that some of them, they have logged in 2 days back, 2 days, 20 hours before they have logged in, 1 day, 4 hours before they have logged. Some, they have not logged in at all. So you can see here. So any name, if you can just tell me, I can find out here. So total 174 users in this course means all are teachers only, no students.
Sir, I need to find mine because I don't know my username. And
so let me check in the user list. I think I have created. If it is not created, you can just send me the name and like, what's your name, madam?
Sir, Irfana, IRFANA.
So Irfana Anjum, science. It's created already. This is the okay. One?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it's already created. Just use your admission employee code, and then the password is already I have shared the password. It's a common password for all.
Okay.
You can use it.
Okay. Yes. Okay, sir. Thank you.
So it is showing never logged in. So those are logged in, it will show logged in.
Yes, sir. I was a bit confused about this. So today I will.
Yes, yes. You can. Okay. So any questions, you can ask me the question. So otherwise, we'll conclude here. So those are the subject coordinators. They can stay. I'll just give you the access thoroughly. Shugufta, madam, you can delete that. Otherwise, I'll delete it. No issues.
I will delete, ma'am.
Okay, no problem. So just go to the edit and just click on delete. It will ask you 2-3 steps to here. Easily you can delete. It will not ask you 2-3 steps. Easily you can delete.
Sir,